Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the class day celebration of the great Princeton class of 2023. Woo! My name is Ryan.
I'm Zion.
And I'm Douglas.
And we've had the honor of serving as this year's class day co-chairs. First and foremost, let's clap it up. We made it, your thesis is finished. You can take a deep breath, let's go! It is very nice to see you all on this beautiful Princeton day. We hope that you had a safe flight or drive, and most importantly, that you were able to avoid the dangerous flock of scooters. Regardless, you made it, and this day is going to be legendary, just like our class. Begun in 1866, Class Day is an annual celebration organized by and for the senior class. Today, we come together as baby tigers one last time before leaving through the Fitz Randolph gates, and of course, returning at the end of every May with more Princeton spirit than ever. Today, we will showcase some of our funniest seniors, most talented singers, and of course relive some unforgettable memories. From being the first class to ever sell out Ivy Inn at our pub night, to our March Madness Cinderella story, let's hear it for the basketball teams. We're a basketball school. This class is one of a kind and we cannot wait to celebrate it. But first, we want to thank the staff that has worked so hard to set up this event, this whole weekend, and every day on campus. We would not be here without you. Thank you. While the tenor of Class Day is festive and fun, I do want to pause here so that we may all recognize and remember both Kevin Chang and Jazz Chang, who, while they will always be members of the class of 2023, are not with us in person today. I invite all in attendance to join me in a moment of silence as we think of Jazz and Kevin, their classmates, families, and friends who love them dearly. Note that we will always carry them in our hearts as members of the class of 2023. Thank you. Now it is my honor to introduce President Christopher Eisgruber, the 20th president of the university and member of the Princeton class of 1983. On behalf of our entire class, thank you for your leadership. And on behalf of every Whitmanite, thanks for announcing Whitman College as the winner of our Clash of the Colleges. Roll Wales, let's go. Hey! Please join me in welcoming President Eisgruber.
What a pleasure it is to welcome and congratulate Princeton's great class of 2023 on this, the occasion of your Class Day. Class Day is a venerable tradition on this campus. It has been celebrated, as Ryan has already said, at least since before the Civil War. And from 1866 until as recently as 1962, the New York Times regularly covered Princeton's Class Day, naming the student speakers and commenting briefly on their remarks. Much has changed about Class Day over the years. At least one thing, however, has remained the same. The senior class, not the university administration, organizes and presides over Class Day. In the words of the great class of 1898, Class Day is a day over which the graduating class has full charge and which we run to suit ourselves. To recognize both this long-standing tradition and to honor the maturity and education of the almost graduated senior class, class day begins with a ceremony in which the president of the university entrusts the metaphorical keys to the university to the leaders of the senior class. As you can see from the pictures up on the screen, we treat this metaphor very literally, and I can assure you that we always treat these valuable and precious objects with the care and veneration they deserve. I turn over the keys to you this year with special confidence. After we get them back, I turn over the keys to you this year with special confidence. Your class has demonstrated excellent judgment by selecting Congresswoman Terry Sewell, a university trustee and graduate of the great class of 1986, as your class day speaker. And more fundamentally, your class has proven itself capable of great things by maintaining high levels of achievement during one of the most difficult periods that our university, our nation, and our world have ever faced. I would now ask your alumni officers to come forward to receive the keys to the university. Congratulations to the great class of 2023. Enjoy your class day.
Thank you, President Eisgruber, for your words and your leadership. It is now my pleasure to introduce one of the kindest people that I know and the true meaning of friendship, love, and joy, our class president, Terrence Seba. I first met Taryn when she randomly approached me as I was running for class council freshman year and wished me good luck and mentioned how excited she was that I was running. Sadly, I did not win that election, but our class 100% correctly chose to elect Taryn because she is genuinely a light to this campus and our class. No one can name every single 23 class member except her. No one can bring a smile to the faces of everyone she encounters like her. And no one is more deserving to stand in front of us as our class president in the spirit of the class of 2023. Her love for every single one of us is genuine, deep, and compassionate. It is not forced nor performative, but she has a deep love for people and everyone around us. When my grandmother passed away in December, she was one of the first people to message me and told me stories of her own love for her grandfather. She consistently reminds me of her passion for education and the world. Her love for empowering all voices and communities, and her unabashed Princeton pride. Have you seen that Princeton tattoo on her lips? So,
maybe later.
It is 100% my honor to introduce one of the best things about this university, our class, and our community, our president, Taryn.
How's everyone doing today? Yeah? I love you too. So good morning to the great class of 2023 and to the villages of supporters who have gotten us through our time at Princeton. Thank you so much for being here today. Before I begin, I'd like to take a moment to thank the Office of the Dean of Undergraduate Students and University Administrators, facility workers, staff, faculty, and our incredible 2023 Student Commencement Committees, whose hard work has made these festivities possible. Please join me in thanking them. Woo!
I'd also like to preface that I am no great speechwriter or orator. I've been at a loss for words to describe how much our great class means to me, to encapsulate all that we've been through, and to detail the tenacity of who we are. I debated having ChatGPT write my speech, but I was worried that our classmate Edward Tian would find out and report me. So please forgive the limitations of my human-generated words. So, in reflecting on many of our favorite moments at Princeton, from our first lawn parties to the last dance reunions, the song Mr. Brightside by The Killers has been the soundtrack to the movie that has been these past 4 years. We frequently hear that our class is unprecedented and resilient, which is true, but I'd rather posit that our class is unified by audacious optimism, persistent hope, unwavering support for one another, and a tendency to always look at the bright side. This was true for us before we even stepped foot onto campus. When we applied, instead of seeing the 96% rejection rate, we were determined to make up the 4% of admitted students. I think about and am deeply inspired by the many of us who are the first in their families to go to college, to be the first, let alone the first to go to the number one school in the country, is nothing short of remarkable. And I think of our international community who have come from worlds away and have made Princeton their second home. Woo, yeah, international students. And I think of the empowerment and celebration of female students, leaders, and faculty across campus, historically marking 50 years of coeducation. Women. I think of how, when we received the news that we were being sent home because of a pandemic, that our class, at odds with public health guidelines, stampeded to late meal, held one another, and sang our hearts out to karaoke. Then, while we were physically apart, our class was more than determined to stay together. Our 2023 highlight series, slated to last only for a few weeks, ended up going for over a year and featured hundreds of you. Through Zoom calls and FaceTimes, we intimately stayed connected, getting glimpses into your homes, the opportunity to chat with your families, and of course, the view of Zoom bombing siblings and pets. And so, while our time apart was difficult, our class never bemoaned, and instead cherished the time we had together. Across every dimension, 2023s showed up, made the most of what we were given, and have left Princeton a better place. For example, I think of Jennifer Lee, who, after being diagnosed with a chronic illness, founded the Asian Americans with Disabilities Initiative to uplift marginalized voices. I think of Patrick Glory, who became Princeton's first NCAA wrestling champion in 72 years. Yeah! I think of Daniel, Ben, Moyne, and Alkin, who turned poor air quality into an opportunity to develop affordable air monitors to increase well-being and safety for all. I think of Kevin, yes. I think of Kevin and Giselle, who reinvigorated Latino affinity groups on campus and increased cultural pride and awareness. I think of Jared, who beat stage 4 cancer and whose physics thesis research pioneered the synergies and mimicry between how birds flock together and how the cells in our body communicate with one another. Like, whoa. Oh, Giselle. I think of the critically important work of the Emma Bloomberg Center. I think of the historic run by the men's and women's basketball teams. Yes. I think of Laura Wooten, the longtime Butler College dining hall employee whose name graces a campus building in honor of her 79 years of civic service as a poll worker. I think of the incredible advocacy across campus that has reckoned with historic and systemic injustices, has resulted in the partial divestment of fossil fuels, iconography that reflects Princeton past, present, and future, and the recognition of American Sign Language for credit, all efforts that have made campus more accessible, inclusive, and kind. And so I think of everyone who have written entire books and have conducted groundbreaking research after only taking one semester of writing seminar. In so many ways, I see Sarah from my writing set. In so many ways, every one of you has remained radically optimistic, has built bridges over divides, has shown kindness in response to hatred, and has exhibited resiliency in the face of adversity. May you continue to use the barriers presented to you as stepping stones to even greater potentials. And so, when reflecting on our time at Princeton, we hopefully won't remember the problem sets or the late nights, but rather the people. Not only do you all always look at the bright side, but you are the bright side of Princeton. And in homage to the 3 and 23, I would like to leave you with 3 wishes as you embark on your journey. The first one, I wish that the best of your todays are the worst of your tomorrows. My second wish for you is to rejoice and share in the privilege that your hard work has afforded you, to use it in the service of humanity so that all may receive the multiplier effects of these blessings. And my third and final wish for you, with the same curiosity, open hearts, and open minds that you had when entering as first years, I hope that you'll be able to travel to all corners of the world to shine your light and to always find your way back to our beloved orange bubble. In reference to the 3 and 23, or the 2 and 23, sorry, just did 3. I hope the rest of your lives are filled with too much joy and that your cheeks hurt from smiling too wide. I hope your closet is filled with too much orange and that you keep in touch with too many people. And I hope that when asked what your favorite part of college was, that you'll have too many amazing memories to be able to choose one. So, to the great class of 2023, we'll be coming out of Fitz Randolph Gates and we'll be doing just fine. On behalf of myself and my amazing class council that has become my family, Fatina, Emily, Eric and Jake, thank you for the incredible privilege of serving, knowing, and growing with you. Destiny is calling you 2023, so open up your eager eyes because you're Mr. Brightside. Thank you, 2023. Love you, 2023. And a resounding congratulations to the greatest class of 2023.
It is now my privilege to introduce the Dean of Undergraduate Students, Kathleen Degnan. Dean Degnan and the office that she oversees have tirelessly worked to support the co-curricular experience and to empower students to contribute to our university community in meaningful ways. After 39 years as an administrator at Princeton and 24 years leading the office of the Dean of Undergraduate Students, Dean Degnan will retire this summer. Please join us in a round of applause as we thank and congratulate Dean Degnan. We now invite Dean Degnan to present the Class Day prizes.
It is customary during Class Day festivities to acknowledge the winners of the Moses Taylor Pine Honor Prize, awarded annually to that member of the senior class who has most clearly manifested scholarship, strength of character, and effective leadership in support of Princeton University. The Pine Prize, which is the highest honor the university confers upon an undergraduate, was presented this year at Alumni Day to Austin Davis and Ella Gantman. Austin and Ella, would you please stand so that we can acknowledge your achievements? Alan Macy Dulles Class of 51 Service Award. An alumnus of the Class of 1951 generously endowed this award to honor his classmate, Alan Macy Dulles, who, seriously injured in the Korean War, set an example of selflessness and courage that are the spirit of this prize. The official description of the award is as follows. Presented each year to the senior whose activities while a Princeton student best represent or exemplify Princeton in the nation's service and in the service of humanity. The Alan Macy Dulles 51 Award is presented this year to Isha Jain. Isha, a School of Public and International Affairs concentrator from Parsippany, New Jersey, has earned certificates in environmental studies and South Asian studies. Isha has a remarkable record of service on our campus and beyond. Isha has her tireless work to serve others aligns perfectly with the values reflected in Princeton's unofficial motto. Isha served as an intern with the Santa Judeo Foundation for Peace and Dialogue, a humanitarian organization concerned with supporting the poor and the homeless and fostering peace building in regions in crisis. In her work for the foundation, she helped map networks of churches that supported the peacemaking efforts in Sudan and volunteered with the homeless population in New York City, tutoring children and delivering meals to those in need. Isha has also served as the lead intern for the United Nations Women's Fellowship, helping to connect Princeton students to the UN mission and its projects, scheduling speakers from diverse religious and cultural backgrounds, and supporting international diplomatic efforts concerned with gender justice. Among her on-campus activities, Isha is a coordinator of the Religious Life Council, serves as an RCA in Butler College, and is a member of the Business Today and Conservation Society. She also performs with the Princeton South Asian Theater. Please join me in congratulating Isha for her dedication to bettering the lives of others.
Thank you.
You are welcome.
Thank you so much.
Good luck.
Thank you.
The Frederick Douglass Service Award, established in 1969 by the Association of Black Collegians, is awarded annually to a senior who has exhibited courage, leadership, intellectual achievement, and a willingness to contribute unselfishly toward a deeper understanding of the experiences of racial minorities, and who, in so doing, reflects the tradition of service embodied in a Princeton education. This year, the winner of the Frederick Douglass Award is Angelica Chin. Angelica is a sociology concentrator from Princeton Junction, New Jersey, earning a certificate in Asian American Studies and in theater. She has left her mark on many areas of student life, but has worked most visibly to create more inclusive spaces across the arts at Princeton, and as a volunteer mentor for underserved youth in Princeton and Trenton. As a strong advocate for the arts, she has promoted efforts to expand the reach of theater opportunities on campus, making the arts more inclusive and representative of Princeton's diverse student body. An active member of the campus theater community, Angelica serves as a student advisor for the Lewis Center for the Arts, a student stage management mentor in the program in theater, and as president of the student organization, East West Theater. She also serves as the diversity and inclusion officer for Theater on Team. As a volunteer, Angelica's commitment to mentorship has been both genuine and sustained. She has been a volunteer and executive board co-chair of Community House here on campus, and has served as an advisor for Matriculate, an organization dedicated to helping high-achieving, low-income students prepare for college. As a RISE Fellow, she worked with Homeworks in Trenton, an organization providing academic and leadership enrichment to low-income, first-generation girls of color. Please join me in congratulating Angelica. The Harold Willis Dodds Award is an annual award established in 1957 to be given to the senior who best embodies the high example set by Harold Willis Dodds during his tenure as 15th president of Princeton University, particularly in the qualities of clear thinking, moral courage, a patient and judicious regard for the opinions of others, and a thoroughgoing devotion to the life of the mind and the welfare of the university. This year, the winner of the Harold Willis Dodds Award is Preeti Chimiti. A School of Public and International Affairs concentrator from Fort Collins, Colorado. Hailing from Riverton, Utah, Preeti is a concentrator. Sorry about that. The wind blew my page. Preeti is a concentrator in the School of Public and International Affairs, who has earned certificates in history and the practice of diplomacy and values in public life. Throughout her time at Princeton, Preeti has been an exceptionally thoughtful listener and a high-impact contributor. She has served as a Field Center Fellow, as the editor-in-chief of the Princeton Political Review, and has participated in mock trial. As a Maddie College RCA, a peer academic advisor, and a college council member, Preeti has consistently displayed patience and respect for all voices. She exhibited these same qualities as a student representative on the Tiger Well Committee, working to review programmatic proposals to support health and well-being on campus. One of Preeti's most significant contributions, however, was during the pandemic, when she authored Mind Matters, a guidebook on Princeton's mental health resources published during our campus transition to remote instruction. In discussions about student health and well-being, Preeti displayed uncommon balance and leadership, highlighting the many resources provided by Princeton during this challenging and isolating time, but also working constructively towards continuous improvement, organizing and distributing resource information in partnership with the undergraduate student government. Please join me in congratulating Preeti. The next two awards are voted by the members of the senior class. The W. Sanderson Detweiler 1903 Prize is a silver bowl awarded annually to the senior in the judgment of the student's classmate who has done the most for the class. The prize was founded in 1949 in memory of W. Sanderson Detweiler, class of 1903, by his sister, Mrs. William Jennings Price. This year's winner is Taryn Seba.
Big surprise. Now, this person is actually from Fort Collins, yes. Colorado. Taryn is earning certificates in Latin American Studies and Latino Studies and is concentrating in the School of Public and International Affairs. She has been involved in class government since she arrived at Princeton, serving as your class president for the last 3 years. Taryn has led a loyal core of your class officers in promoting class unity. Under her leadership, your class enjoyed an amazing array of successful activities, such as the Orange and Black Ball, all the senior commencement activities, and the senior sunset soiree, where you and your classmates raised your glasses in a toast to friendship and lasting memories. In addition to her role as a class officer, Taryn has been a dedicated university citizen, serving as an Orange Key tour guide, a dormitory assistant, and as a Vote 100 ambassador for Colorado, encouraging students to register and to vote. Taryn has also served as a representative on many university committees, including the USG's Social, Mental Health, and Academics Committee, as well as the Honor Committee. While her selfless efforts to sponsor events, distribute gear, and foster fellowship among members of your class has been a constant, Her efforts were especially important during the pandemic, when creating community and class unity was especially challenging. Taryn, a grateful class of 2023, thanks you for your leadership and your hard work. Congratulations. And finally, the Class of 1901 Medal is awarded to the senior who, in the judgment of the student's classmates, has done the most for Princeton. Founded in 1920 by the Class of 1901, which in 1952 endowed it in perpetuity and stipulated that thereafter the medal be awarded in memory of its classmate, Walter E. Hope, who originated the prize. This year, the winner is Mayu Takeuchi. Mayu is a concentrator in the School of Public and International Affairs, earning her certificate in values and public life. Born in Tokyo, Japan, and raised in Watkinsville, Georgia, Mayu has been deeply involved in campus life, serving as undergraduate student government president, USG Sustainability Committee chair, as a violinist in the Princeton University Orchestra, and a drummer in Tora Taiko, a traditional Japanese drumming group. Mayu has demonstrated a deep commitment to the welfare of our campus, but also to our planet. She served as executive director of the New Jersey Student Climate Advocates and as a part of the Princeton Environmental Activism Coalition. She has also coordinated winter session workshops and other educational climate initiatives. Mayu has led teams of students that partnered with administrators to take a systematic approach to reviewing and improving campus mental health resources and policies, and helped bring students to the table in dialogue around fossil fuel divestment and dissociation. For all that she has done to advocate for and improve the student experience on campus, promote awareness, education, and care for our environment, and for how hard she has worked to build consensus among stakeholders, her peers have voted to recognize her with the Class of 1901 Medal. Congratulations, Mayu, and thank you for your many contributions to this university.
Thank you, Dean Degnan, and congratulations, everyone. It is now my honor to introduce our first class herald, Peyton Krosky. Peyton is an African American Studies major with a certificate in Applications of Computing. On campus, she is the creative content director of the Ida B. Wells Just Data Lab, a member of AAS Undergraduate Board of Advisors, and a dancer with the Black Arts Collective. Peyton told us that after graduation, she is most excited to join the quote-unquote Princeton cult. So, without further ado, please welcome Peyton, who will issue some class superlatives, very interesting, and tell you more about this Princetonian cult that we students know and love.
Hello and good morning to the Princeton community and, of course, the great class of 2023. And a special hello to all the non-Princetonians out there. I know the blindingly bright orange cult-like rituals and stench of elitism can be a lot to handle, but please, please hang in there. You're the closest thing to normal some of these graduates will ever see in their lifetime. Now, as I'm sure we've all heard from the depressing news cycle and endless stream of never-before-seen events, we are living in unprecedented times. From a global pandemic, to a pending world war, to my sneaking suspicion that there are aliens roaming among us, there is no doubting the strangeness of this moment in history. We're even the first class to experience Princeton PC pre-COVID, DC during COVID, and WTDCSWGENNHB. We're tired of dealing with COVID, so we're gonna establish a new normal and hope for the best. Throughout these unprecedented times, we've also lived to see the first late meal area crowded to the brim with students hugging and crying about losing their friends, which, may I add, was a terrible way to respond to the announcement of an airborne virus on campus. We've also witnessed our loved ones being snatched away and locked in a faraway tower, AKA Butler isolation housing. And we even attended the strangest lawn parties in Princeton's history, brought to you by Jason Derulo dancing in his kitchen. Oh, and there was also that one semester where they didn't season any of the food because they assumed COVID had already stolen all of our taste buds. Yeah, we've really seen it all. But it wasn't all bad. We unprecedented some good times as well. Special shout out to the class of 23's very own Timwa Mashake, who recently became the first trustee from Zambia. Let's give it up for him. This class is truly something special. This year alone, we established Princeton as not just extra nerdy, but also surprisingly sporty. You know, we all know about the men and women's basketball teams making it to the NCAA championships, right? Can't let that down. But let us also not forget about the extraordinary athletic achievements of me, who bravely forewent an electric scooter and instead hiked the treacherous hills and valleys of this campus all 4 years. And they said it couldn't be done. Ultimately, our Princeton journey has included many twists and turns. We started off with a bang during our first year with the whole community action underage drinking scandal. Yeah, some of y'all remember that. I was there. And as soon to be alum, we've even mastered the delicate DJing balance between playing Drake's newest hits and covering it with a swell of Unsta Unsta strobe lights and beat drops. Side note, I still don't really know how I'm supposed to dance to the sound of electronics violently crashing and burning, but maybe I'll figure it out next reunions. And fun fact, the Campus Fox is actually a member of the great class of 2023. Yeah, give it up for the Fox. Having made its home on campus in 2019, we've watched our furry peer wait for the dinky, go for late night trips to Wawa, and even do the Whitman whale. And the Fox is even part of the 75% of Princetonians who find love on campus, as evidenced by the four-legged legacies running around Spelman right now. Now, to close, I'd like to recognize a few special members of the great class of 2023 by announcing some superlatives. First up, we have the Most Likely to Be a Reality TV Star Award, which goes to all the residents of Spelman Hall whose entire lives are on display because they refuse to close their blinds. I do live in Spelman. Next, we have the Most Likely to Talk Extensively About Pulling an All-Nighter Award going to students who somehow managed to be in 5 dance groups, an a cappella ensemble, juggling club, and SPIA. Now for the Most Likely to Follow Trends Award going to all the gap year 23s who used the pandemic as an excuse to join the coolest class on campus. And now I have the Most Likely to Be McCoshed, Arrested, Then Elected Award. And that goes to any man in pastel shorts, an unbuttoned shirt revealing his bare chest, and a high-profile father willing to cover up his mess. And last, but certainly not least, we have the Most Likely to Bleed Orange and Enjoy Princeton's Silly Little Traditions, even though their time here has been anything but normal. And that goes to us, the unprecedented class of 2023, who created laughter and joy and beauty and hope out of these strange and unusual times. So here's to us, the new kids on the block who look a little different with our battle scars and weird memories, but ultimately redefined the Princeton experience and created the new normal. Thank you for having me, and happy unprecedented times to the great class of 2023.
Thank you so much, Peyton. I would now like to introduce Kimberly De Los Santos, the director of the Pace Center for Civic Engagement, who will be presenting the Priscilla Glickman Class of 1992 Memorial Prize.
The Priscilla Glickman Class of 1992 Memorial Prize is awarded annually to a Princeton senior who has shown independence and imagination in the area of community service. The prize commends the qualities of curiosity in the world and commitment to its betterment. This year's prize is awarded to Giselle Curbelo. Giselle is empathetic and driven. She is passionate and patient. She has weaved together her academic pursuits and service passions as she seeks to build a community here at Princeton and beyond that supports all of us. As a transfer student and an immigrant, Giselle has, in the words of an academic advisor, navigated differences on multiple scales, with incredible grace and with an eagerness to learn whatever she can in any situation. As a summer intern at the Latin American Legal Defense and Education Fund, Giselle heard the testimonies of people who had experienced external displacement and political repression, and she came to understand how, in her words, their search for safety was met with legal ambiguity. Then, as part of a course, Giselle attended a hearing at Newark Immigration Court, where she saw individuals who did not have the guidance of a legal representative. Her senior thesis is an analysis of Cuban migration, and her advisor says it is a significant achievement for an undergraduate student to attain the trust of people to tell their stories of migration to and legal precarity in the United States. Her peers see this work, how in her courses and in her senior thesis, Giselle has prioritized the importance of engaging with the people directly affected by the abstract concepts discussed within the classroom, and how Giselle has built community amongst Latina students on campus. Giselle, as a former Glickman Prize winner, has said, "You have taken initiative to curate what you wanted your Princeton experience to look like, a journey bigger than yourself, to serve your community and light the path for future students. We are so pleased to honor you, and your journey very much honors the memory of Priscilla Glickman." Congratulations, Giselle.
I now have the honor of introducing John Mack, the Director of Athletics and member of the great Princeton Class of 2000. As a member of the track team, he received the William Winston Roper Trophy as the top student athlete at Princeton. And this year was an incredible year for Princeton Athletics. As we all now know, we are a basketball school. We are. And both the men's and women's basketball team made it to the Sweet 16, making history and making all of us Tigers proud. Give a round of applause for them. In addition to basketball, the school also made history with lacrosse, wrestling, and who could forget the Big Three bonfire last year? John Mack was at the head of these victories. And so please welcome to the stage, John Mack.
Thank you and good morning to the great class of 2023. I want to start off by letting you know I didn't forget what year it was. I wore my class jacket not because I thought it was my class day, but for me it represents my Princeton experience and also what I hope for all of you. This jacket is stained with the residue of too many trips to the 5th, 10th, and now 25th reunion tent. But more importantly, woven into its fabric are our memories of experiences shared with classmates, with friends, with members of the Princeton community, not just here on campus, but around the world. And so because of all of that, this jacket means more to me now than it did when I first put it on 23 years ago. And I hope for each one of you that your Princeton experience, your commitment to this place, to our values, to our identity, and to one another continues to grow year after year. The great class of 2023 is a record-setting athletic class. Whether you were one of our 1,000-plus varsity student-athletes, whether you're a club athlete, an intramural champion, or a workout warrior in Stevens Fitness Center, I want to thank you for helping to advance our mission to make physical fitness and activity and wellness a part of the Princeton undergraduate experience. This year, the Princeton class of 2023 tied Princeton's record for 16 conference championships won in a single academic year. When combined with last year's success, that means the class of 2023 has engineered the greatest two-year run of athletic success in the history of the Ivy League. I want to recognize each year athletics presents awards, a number of awards for our top senior male and female student athletes. This year's recipient of the C. Otto von Kienbusch Award as the top senior female student athlete is Daria Freeman of the women's tennis team. A psychology major from Moscow, Russia, Daria was named the 2023 Ivy League Player of the Year and led the team to a fourth straight Ivy League title, in addition to a third straight NCAA tournament second round appearance. Daria became the first Ivy League women's tennis player to be ranked number one nationally in singles tennis play. She was also ranked as high as number seven in doubles play. Daria is a two-time first-team All-Ivy honoree and was the runner-up at the ITA Fall National Championships in both 2021 and 2022. She's the ITA Northeast Region Rookie of the Year in 2020, and she's amassed a total of 69 singles victories and 48 doubles victories during her career. Congratulations, Daria. This is just a thank you. I'll get it back to you afterwards. This year's recipient of the William Winston Roper Trophy as a top senior male student athlete is Sondre Guttormsen of the men's track and field team. A three-time NCAA champion pole vaulter and first-team All-American, Sondre has rewritten record books on collegiate pole vaulting. His winning jump at the 2023 NCAA Indoor Championship tied the all-time national collegiate record. A four-time Ivy League champion, Sondre has set new Princeton and Ivy League pole vault records both indoors and outdoors. A native of Ski, Norway, Sondre was a 2020 Olympian and is the first Norway pole vaulter to win a European Indoor Championship. In addition to all this, Sondre received the Myers Award for achieving the highest GPA on the men's track and field team, and he'll be competing for his fourth NCAA title at next week's NCAA Outdoor Track and Field Championships. Congratulations, Sondre.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Congratulations and thank you to the great class of 2023.
I'm back again. So I now have the honor to introduce our second class herald, Mr. Gavin Laplace. I have actually had the honor to know Gavin for the last 8 years of my life, as he graduated a year before me from my high school, and I excitedly followed him to Princeton. So when I learned he was taking a bridge year, I was so excited to get to share the Princeton experience with him as a classmate. Gavin is a concentrator in the School of Public and International Affairs. He is an avid performer with the avant-scene Princeton's French Language Theater Group and a witness for Princeton Mock Trial. He also participated in the Bridge Year program in Senegal in 2018 to 2019. Please welcome to the podium one of the funniest, nicest, and best public speakers that I've ever known, Gavin Laplace.
Sorry I came early. I was just too excited to give the speech. Congresswoman Sewell, President Eisgruber, Dean Dolan, Dean Dunn, the 100 other deans and administrators in attendance, parents, guests, and members of the great class of 2023. As an ethical large language model, ChatGPT is unable to write your entire speech for you. Wait, hold on. Good morning. It's great to be here on this beautiful Monday morning, class day. Because if there's one thing we really needed, it was another day of class. Sorry, low-hanging fruit. Don't worry, though. I'm going to keep this speech short and sweet, just like our break sophomore year. Anyway, plowing ahead. Actually, speaking of plowing, is there any part of campus that hasn't been torn to shreds this year? I'm starting to worry the board's only divesting from fossil fuels because they think there's oil under Whitman. I mean, have y'all seen the renderings of Hobson College? Let's be real, that's a refinery. I don't know, maybe I'm too cynical, but can you blame me? The last 4 years have been challenging for all of us in ways big and small. We've been faced with a once-in-a-century pandemic, a generational reckoning with racial injustice, the most polarizing presidential election of our lifetimes, and a looming climate crisis. And on a less existential scale, we've had the weekly COVID tests, forgetting the weekly COVID tests, having our weekly COVID test data sent to the whole school, scooters turning the campus into a human version of Frogger, my own personal nemesis, the Yay College silverware slot, and plenty more besides. But at least the university gave us complimentary 7 a.m. alarms this year to make up for all that. I'm not surprised it's been challenging, though. From what I've heard repeatedly this year, this is supposed to be a rigorous place. And to tell you the truth, for a long time, something about that whole notion didn't sit quite right with me. But I get it now. Because standing up here, looking out at all of you, I can see that this place has prepared us to take on the world. I see so many brave, talented, brilliant investment bankers. I know, I'm generalizing. Some are going into consulting. Anyway, as I was saying, it hasn't always been easy, but it hasn't all been painful either. Far from it. This is, as we all know, a special place, with professors and peers who dare to ask questions that would never even occur to anyone else. For example, where others might ask, how effective are masks at preventing COVID transmission? Here at Princeton, we ask, can I flush the mask down the toilet? For the record, Big Plumbing says no, but you do your own research. Speaking of our own research, I've got to give a shout out to the senior thesis. What an incredible opportunity to write so much and say so little. But in our defense, we had a lot of other things to work on while we pretended to be thesising. I actually had my own pet project that took up a lot of my time, a kind of deep dive into our class to complement the Daily Princetonian Senior Survey that I call 2023 and Me. Now, I won't bore you with all the technical details, but here are just a few of the most striking findings. Before this year, 27% of 23s thought that March Madness referred to the feeling you get when you have 5 midterms during spring semester. 11% of the senior class has at times felt uncomfortable sharing their views on campus. And full disclosure, I am actually among that group, but this seems as good a time as any to break my silence. I'm sorry to break it to you, President Eisgruber, but orange really just isn't your color. Please don't expel me. 3% of the senior class went on bridge year. The other 97% developed well-rounded personalities. Actually, speaking of that, have I mentioned that I did bridge year? 6% of 23s were originally 22s, who wish they hadn't stuck around to graduate with, quote, this bunch of losers, unquote. Ouch. Seniors in canon collectively read an impressive 672 books this year. When asked for comment, most said they enjoyed the plots, but struggled with coloring inside the lines. Sorry. Well, 2023, what can I say? We really are a remarkable group. I mean, just this year, some of us actually made it onto national news. I guess you could say we're taking the country by storm. But speaking seriously, it's been an extraordinary privilege to spend the last 4 years alongside you, both in the Zoomiverse and here at the best damn place of all. And while I can't presume to definitively sum up the experiences of a class as diverse and talented as ours, even though that's kind of the point of this speech, I think there are a few things I can say in closing. Over our 4 years here, we grappled in our classes and conversations with what it means to live a meaningful life and how to understand and improve a world that so often seems so broken. We've built friendships that will last a lifetime, been mentors and mentees, been each other's shoulders to cry on in times of sorrow, and each other's biggest cheerleaders in times of joy. Like when we got to be the first class to PDF writing sim. We've traveled the world, made new discoveries, and quite simply, grown up. And through it all, this institution has watched over and guided us as it has generations of students past and opened up a world of incredible possibilities. Princeton has truly left its mark on us, and we have certainly left our mark on Princeton. I mean, seriously, what other class could have made this place into a basketball powerhouse? I only wish it could have lasted longer. But I guess that's why everyone keeps coming back for reunions. And I have no doubt we'll be loudly and proudly P-rating and locomotiving with the best of them soon enough. Well, my time's running down, so let me say one last thing. As you know, our generation is often maligned as a bunch of snowflakes, but I disagree. 2023, I think we're more like frosted flakes. After all, in the immortal words of Tony the Tiger, we're great! Congratulations, class of 2023, and good luck.
Let's hear it again for Gavin. What a legend. It is now my honor to call to the stage the 2023 class officers, who will recognize this year's honorary class members for their hard work and notable impact on our lives. I'd like to begin with our lovely and legendary Vice President, Fatina Albiz.
Thank you, Cece, for the warm welcome, and thank you to all the Class Day co-chairs for impeccably organizing this wonderful program. Good morning, everyone, and congratulations to the great class of 2023. My name is Fatina Albiz, and I serve as the class of 2023 Vice President. It is with the greatest honor that I would like to begin the induction of honorary class members into our great class. To begin the induction ceremony, please join me in welcoming Dean Clara Pinciero onto the stage. Right here. Dean Pinciero graduated from Princeton in 2013 with her AB in sociology and was a goalkeeper on the Princeton women's varsity soccer team. Following her undergraduate journey, Dean Pinciero worked as an admissions officer in the Office of Admissions and as a leadership program coordinator in the Office of the Dean of Undergraduate Students at Princeton. She then completed her master's in higher education from the prestigious Harvard Graduate School of Education. After holding roles in leadership, residential life, and community standards at Harvard University and Amherst College, Claire returned home to Princeton as the Assistant Dean and Director of Student Life at Yale College. Now as Dean Pinciero, she works closely with residential college advisors, her Yale College colleagues, and many other undergraduate students to uplift her mentees and weave together the rich fabric of our Princeton community. I would like to share a personal anecdote that encapsulates the profound impact that Claire has had on my life. During my first year when I was elected to 2023 class council, I had the privilege of having Claire as my Otis advisor. As her mentee, I experienced firsthand the dedication Dean Pinciero brings to her students. She believed in me and my potential to thrive at Princeton and provided invaluable guidance as I found my place at Princeton amidst the tumultuous challenges posed by the COVID-19 pandemic. I'm confident that many of us in the great class of 2023 have similarly benefited from Claire's generosity, positive spirit, gracious attitude, and utmost kindness. Claire was sincerely missed during her time away from Princeton. As a fun fact, it is worth noting that Dean Pinciero's office in Yale College stands directly above her former soccer field, an unmistakable sign that Princeton itself had been eagerly preparing to welcome Claire back home. Throughout the past year, each encounter with Dean Pinciero on campus not only fills me with excitement as I update her on my many endeavors since our last conversation, but also evokes glimpses of the young first year I once was, who turned to Claire for her advice, wisdom, and shoulder to lean on. It is with the utmost honor that I would like to extend an invitation to Dean Claire Pinciero to join the great class of 2023 as an honorary class member.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Emily Chu, and I serve as the 2023 class treasurer. At this moment, I would like to invite Professor Ann Chang onto the stage. It brings me great pleasure on behalf of the class of 2023 to name Professor Ann Lin Chang as an honorary member of the great class of 2023. Professor Chang graduated from Princeton in the great class of 1985 and had an extensive career from obtaining a PhD in comparative literature to teaching at a lesser known Ivy League school named Harvard before coming back home to Princeton to be a professor of English. She is the author of three incredible books and is the founder and organizer of the public conversation series, Critical Encounters, which stirs conversation around cross-disciplinary actions for social justice. Additionally, she's an affiliated faculty member in the program of American Studies, specifically in helping develop and transform Asian American Studies, the program of Gender and Sexuality Studies, and the Committee of Film Studies. As a former student of Professor Chang, I had the privilege of witnessing her great intellect up close. She exhibits exceptional leadership and commitment that goes above what is expected and has facilitated programs that impact generations of students to come. However, her achievements are only a small fraction to reflect who she is. What I and other students will remember most is her enthusiasm to teach, her compassion towards her students, and her interest in students inside and outside of the classroom. Thank you, Professor Chang, for all that you do for this university and for the great class of 2023. Please join me in welcoming Professor Ann Chang as an honorary member of the class of 2023.
Good morning. My name is Jake Snyder, and I've had the pleasure to serve as the social chair for our great class. Thank you. The last 4 years have certainly been full of surprises. Even today, we have surprises. But we thought we had time for one more, so I would now like to invite Dean Kathleen Degnan back to the podium. Kathleen Degnan joined the university in fall of 1983, when the original residential college system for all first-year students launched on campus. intended as a solution to help address what was, at the time, a perception of fragmented campus social life. In her work in the Office of the Dean of Undergraduate Students, she oversaw the undergraduate conduct system, supervised RCAs, supported the centers, and played an instrumental role in the establishment of the former LGBT Center, now the GSRC, along with the renaming, relocation, and renovating of the Carl A. Field Center for Equality and Cultural Understanding. Now in the fourth decade of her Princeton career, she has continued to advocate for improving the student experience as a key partner in the evolution of the original 5 2-year residential colleges to what is currently 7 4-year colleges, offering students a home of and sense of belonging, as well as overseeing staff, including the assistant deans for student life and RLCs, who focus on student well-being and college programs. In the course of her work, the university has called on Dean Degnan to take on some of the most difficult challenges on campus, sharing guidance and offering support and resources to students during major campus crises, from campus fires and floods to national disasters like 9/11 or global ones like the pandemic. In those challenging moments, Dean Degnan has always been motivated by deeply held principles of compassion and integrity. She's also led an office in what many ways supports Princeton's defining experience, co-curricular activities and events. Foundational programs such as orientation and lawn parties and student organizations and student government are all supported by her leadership. She's been among Princeton's greatest stewards. For her service to this institution, it is my honor to introduce Dean Kathleen Degnan to the roles of Princeton's class of 2023.
Hello and good morning, great class of 2023. My name is Eric Skalenka, and I'm the class secretary for 23. I would now like to welcome Mr. Joe Coraggio to the stage. Joe Coraggio grew up in Brooklyn, New York, where he attended school at Brooklyn College. After attending Brooklyn College, Joe went to attend New York University, where he has worked since for nearly 30 years, and then at McGraw-Hill Publishing. After this point in his career, Joe took an early retirement. But as someone who wore many hats throughout his entire life, he found himself at Princeton, where he fortunately has been since. On campus, Joe has worked at Forbes College Dining and has been known by all who met him. And has been known by all who met him as a kind-hearted and beloved worker for all Forbesians and to the entire Princeton community alike. What made Joe selected by this class was his ability to maintain and sustain sincere care and concern for the students of Forbes, where he has been known to be an expert at community building. Students have remarked that he continuously checks in with each and every member of Forbes College and notices small but impactful details to make someone's day. Even during the pandemic, when students have felt isolated, Joe has been the glue through which students have felt their Princeton experience all the more brighter during such trying times on campus. Classmates, staff, and the families and friends of 2023, please join me in congratulating Mr. Joe Coraggio, honorary member of the great Princeton University class of 2023.
It is my distinct honor to be able to introduce this year's Class Day speaker, United States Congresswoman Terry Sewell. A member of the great class of 1986 and one of Princeton's most active and engaged alumni, Congresswoman Sewell is no stranger to the university. Congresswoman Sewell was born in Selma, Alabama, the proud daughter of two educators. She's been making history from a young age, notably as the first Black valedictorian of Selma High School and as the first graduate of her high school to attend an Ivy League institution. Yeah. Congresswoman Sewell navigated a vastly different Princeton University than the one that we are all accustomed to. Her class was the very first to experience the residential college system, and she received her diploma only 13 years after the first undergraduate class that included women for all 4 years. The Carl A. Field Center had only opened a few years prior to her arrival on campus, and it was then known as the Third World Center. As a student, Congresswoman Sewell concentrated in the School of Public and International Affairs. She was an inaugural member of Maddie College and Rally the Tigers as a dedicated member of the cheerleading team. The class of 2023 stands on her and her class's shoulders. After walking through Fitz Randolph Gate in 1986, the Congresswoman matriculated to the University of Oxford with a Commonwealth Scholarship, where she studied politics and earned her master's degree. After returning to the United States and earning her Juris Doctorate from a really obscure and underground school in Cambridge, Massachusetts, she worked as both a judicial clerk and attorney in her home state of Alabama and New York. In the early 2000s, she was inspired to pursue a career in public service, leading her to enter and win her first congressional race in 2010. She has represented Alabama's 7th Congressional District ever since. With her victory in 2010, Sewell once again made history, this time as the first Black woman to ever serve in the state of Alabama's congressional delegation. Now, as our class gets ready to transition from being students to alumni, there is no better person to speak about the importance of remaining involved and engaged in the life of our soon-to-be alma mater. Since graduating Princeton, Congresswoman Sewell has returned to campus many times in a variety of settings where she is engaged with and invested in the current generation of Princetonians. She also accepted the call to serve as the university as a member of the Board of Trustees beginning in 2019, where she has influenced some of the university's most strategic initiatives. Congresswoman Sewell's story is Princeton's story. Please join us in thanking her for her work and, most importantly, in welcoming her home.
To the mighty, unprecedented class of 2023, congratulations! To President Eisgruber, to the Board of Directors and Trustees, administrators, faculty, staff, parents, friends, and all who are assembled, good morning. It is indeed overwhelming for me to return home to Princeton as your 2023 Class Day speaker. As I look across the audience, I can't help but remember my own college graduation. For me, college was an exciting and transformational time in my life. College was what I call the wonder years. You know, I wonder if my classmate likes me. I wonder if I got that visa bill before my parents. You know, the wonder years. I have also fond memories of my college graduation. I remember the excitement of beginning a new chapter in my life. The burst of pride of my family felt as they watched me receive my degree. I remember the exhilaration of a myriad of friends of mine who gathered around us. We hoped, we dreamed, we prayed about our next chapter. I remember a lot about my graduation day and my class day, but I don't remember the class day speaker. I hope you do. So I'll try to be brief. I can't tell you how excited I am to be with you all today. My love of Princeton stems from a deep appreciation of how much this institution helped shape, mold, and nurture me as the public servant that I am today. However, I wasn't the only Sewell who loved Princeton. My parents seemed to love this place even more than I did. The moment they stepped on this campus, they got a cap that read P86. That's parent of 86. Princeton had a special place in my parents' heart. As you all know, our Princeton graduation is not just an event. It is a full-blown experience. My parents saw the parade, experienced reunions. I think my dad drank a beer at every tent he encountered. We ate at my eating club, Cap and Gown, where we met Brooke Shields, class of 87. We attended numerous receptions and my parents even went to my prom. Now, can your family still go to the prom these days? Yeah. Some traditions never change. My parents loved the whole weekend. My daddy especially enjoyed the simplicity of the baccalaureate service, the spirit of class day, and the pomp and circumstances of commencement. As you know, I have been a perpetual student all my life, making my dad a self-proclaimed connoisseur of graduations. After attending my 3 graduations from Princeton, Oxford, and Harvard Law School, my dad professed that he was indeed an expert on graduation. When Harvard Law School passed out boxed lunches after their ceremony, my dad literally walked up to the dean of Harvard Law School and said, "This is the worst graduation I've ever attended. It is peasant compared to Princeton." Now, Princeton, they set it out. It's a family affair. If my dad's observations are true, parents, no matter how many degrees your child may obtain, you're currently experiencing the best graduation ever. I'm sure my dad is smiling from heaven that I got a chance to experience the Princeton graduation twice. I get a do-over. No longer will I be the class of 1986. From this day forward, I am happy to be the honorary member of the class, the unprecedented class of 2023. And for that, I say thank you. Today, like generations of graduates before you, you will walk through the Fritz Randolph Gate. You will do so undoubtedly resolved to succeed. After all, you're Princeton students. But you will also do so, I hope, by keeping in mind the mandate of Princeton's motto, to be in the nation's service and the service of humanity. Because class of 2023, our nation needs you. We need your humanity. We need your compassion. We need your brilliance. We need you to serve. And that's what I'm going to talk about today. Now, I too have 3 wishes for the class of 2023. First, bloom where you're planted. Next, flourish where you're found. And lastly, spread seeds of service wherever you go. The truth is, graduates, you don't have to go far to make a difference in this world. You can, as my mother would say, bloom where you're planted. I grew up in Selma, Alabama. In fact, I was born the same year as the March from Selma to Montgomery, just 2 months before Bloody Sunday, just a few blocks away from the Edmund Pettus Bridge. Growing up in Selma, our nation's heroes were my neighbors. Growing up in Selma, I was reminded every day of the powerful change that ordinary people can ignite. Growing up in Selma, I remembered that one day it would be my responsibility to ignite that change. So when I had the opportunity to go from Selma to Princeton, it was with that responsibility in mind. It was a big change to come here from Selma, Alabama. I was 1,000 miles from home, and it seemed light years away from the sense of history that I grew up with. Still, I was resolved to do deep in my roots to do what I can to help home. I remember when I met my freshman classmate, and she was my roommate, Maddie Hall. I think it was Campbell, Maddie College, Campbell Hall. Anybody know about Maddie? Whoa. I've always been proud of being from Selma. When I told her that I was from Selma, Alabama, my roommate literally gasped, "Oh my God, how did you escape?" As if I had come on an underground railroad. To which I repeated, "Delta Airlines, there are 3 flights daily." Another time, I was introduced to a senior who had one of those last names that I should have known. Like one of those names that are on one of these buildings. When I didn't react to his last name, he said, "Don't you know that I'm a 3rd generation Princetonian?" To which I replied, Well, excuse my manners. I failed to properly introduce you to me. You see, my name is Terry Sewell. You know, the Sewells of Selma. Now, you would have thought that I was an heir to the throne of some African country instead of the daughter of a high school basketball coach and a school librarian. After I graduated, and then graduated again, and then graduated again, at those inferior, vastly inferior graduation ceremonies, I didn't go home to Alabama at first. My student loans from Harvard Law School led me to New York City to work at a big law firm where I practiced corporate law for 7 years. The good news is I finally paid off my student loans. The even better news is that I'm fighting in Congress so that you don't have student loans. I went back to Selma and to Alabama when my dad had a massive stroke that left him in a wheelchair. At the end of the day, I wanted to have no regrets. It was one thing to send money home. It was another thing to send myself. My parents needed me. As the oldest and the only girl, it was a tough decision. But seeing the smile on my dad's face for the next 14 years when he survived that stroke was worth it. I realized when I got home that the truth of my mom's words, bloom where you're planted. I didn't have to look far to find things that needed changing in my state of Alabama and in my hometown. To be clear, my hometown needed help. My hometown needed my help. Even though Selma stands on hallowed grounds, it is still a distressed city and heartbreaking place to live for far too many. It was and still is the poorest district in the state of Alabama, which is one of the poorest states in this nation. Nearly 1 in 3 people live below the poverty line in my district. The economic freedom that the civil rights activists won through the vote seemingly passed over the place where they fought and died for it. And yet, I know what's possible. Possible from my hometown with opportunities and resources. My life's journey is a living testament to it. I remember the exact moment I decided to run for Congress. I was sitting in my usual pew in my home church, the historic Brown Chapel AME Church. Any AMEs in the house? When my law school classmate, then Senator Barack Obama, came to speak in Selma during his presidential run in 2027. He talked about the Moses generation that day from the pulpit. He talked about the generation of John Lewis that marched for civil rights and voting rights. And then he talked about the Joshua generation, those of us who have benefited from those victories. He asked, "What will the Joshua generation do to fulfill the debt owed to the generation who paved the way for us?" And I felt like he was talking to me. It was a real turning point in my life. I realized that I was no longer the 17-year-old that came onto Princeton's campus. Now I was a full-blown adult, and it was my generation's turn to lead. What would I do? So, Terry Sewell, you know the Sewells of Selma, decided to run for Congress. And guess what? Mr. Third Generation Princetonian even wrote a check. Class of 2023, authors say write what you know. Artists say paint what you see. And my mother says bloom where you're planted. You can make a difference right where you are. Each of you comes from somewhere that would be better served by your help, your service. You know your communities, the schools, the churches, the small businesses on Main Street. You know the problems. You know the potential. You can make a difference right where you're from. Class of 2023, my second wish for you is to flourish where you are found. Now, Selma formed me, but Princeton found me. My road to Princeton was paved with many benefactors. It was the Princeton alumni, Julian McPhillips, class of 1968, who first introduced me to Princeton. He had read an article about me buried very deep in the Montgomery Advertiser, the local paper, and called my high school guidance counselor to invite me to a gathering at his house the following week to learn more about Princeton. He wouldn't take no for an answer. Princeton found me. At the student gathering at his house, I was unusually antisocial, preferring to hang out by the dining room where the food table was laid out. His wife was very good at making pimento cheese. Really good pimento cheese. So I stood over the buffet to eat the pimento cheese. There was a woman who joined me at the buffet and took particular interest in what I liked and the high school that I attended. She talked to me about what classes I enjoyed. She asked me about my debate experience. And she also listened to me sing Valley High because South Pacific was the play that I was going to be in next week. It turned out that she was a Princeton admissions officer who was a speaker at the gathering. Months later, Debbie Nelson would stay on me to complete my application to Princeton. Princeton found me. I beat the odds when I was admitted to Princeton. While I was valedictorian of Selma High School, a public high school that had never sent a person to an Ivy League school, I was still woefully unprepared for the rigors of Princeton. And yet, because of this institution's commitment to diversity, a commitment far ahead of its time, I was accepted, and then given every opportunity and every resource to catch up. Princeton found me. There wasn't that many minority students when I attended Princeton in the 80s. So then we had upper-class African-American students who would adopt freshman students. My big sister walked into the room, and she was none other than Michelle Robinson. Now, you may know her as Michelle Robinson Obama, class of 1985. It was because of Michelle that I completed my science requirement. Yes, geology 101, rocks for jocks. Princeton found me. I recall when my entire family drove me to Princeton to drop me off. My mom bumped into the then university president, William Bowen. He gave me his card and he gave one to my mother. He said if I ever needed anything to look him up. I am sure President Bowen gave his card to a lot of freshmen that day, but I'm pretty sure that none of them actually took him up on his offer. You see, I took Economics 101 taught by Alan Blinder, who wrote the book, and I had never heard of a supply curve or a demand curve. Distressed by my poor performance on the midterm, my mother suggested that I go visit that nice young man who gave me his card. I told my mother that nice young man was the president of the university. Turns out that President Bowen actually had office hours. Who knew? Most people didn't. I got there early, thinking that there would be a long line waiting to see the president. It was just me. When I arrived to his office, I was so nervous. I got there, like I said, 30 minutes ahead of time. And I can remember when he opened the door, the feeling that was in my throat. I started to cry when he opened the door. He quickly gave me his handkerchief and he said to me, "What's the problem?" And I looked him dead in the face and I said, "I'm failing!" And he said, "Well, let me see that midterm." And then I handed out my dad's green American Express card that he gave me for emergencies only. I said, "I need a tutor. My dad will pay for it." He said, "I think I have a small budget and a little bitty endowment. Please put your card away." I will never forget President Bowen's face as he peered over his glasses towards me. He looked at me and then the midterm paper. He looked at me and then the midterm paper again. He finally said, "You do realize that an 87 is a B. To which I replied through my tears, but I don't make bees. I handed over my dad's card one more time, and of course he didn't take it. He looked at me and he said, in your academic life, you will make bees. But I know that you're not ready to make it today, so we'll give you a tutor. Princeton found me, and President Bowen rescued me. 20 years later, when I was running for Congress, my finance director heard that story about President Bowen and found his number and decided to call him. I was nervous because I didn't think he would remember me. It had been 20-plus years. His assistant answered, and I introduced myself. I'm Terry Sewell, Princeton class of 86, calling for President Bowen. There was a long pause as I debated whether I should hang up. Surely he would not remember me. But then he answered. He answered and he said, is this Terry, I don't make bees, from Selma, Alabama? I said, yes. And he said, a little birdie told me that the girl from Selma wanted to represent Selma. It was a good fundraising call. Princeton found me. I was encouraged to run for Congress a second time by a friend who had gone to Dartmouth College. I knew her as Tina Rutnick, but you may know her as Senator Kirsten Gillibrand of New York. Well, in that case, Dartmouth found me, but nevertheless, I am grateful for all the opportunities that Princeton education has afforded me. My proudest moment was not the day that I graduated and walked through those gates. It was 5 years later when Princeton admitted April Young, another black student from Selma High School, to this transformational opportunity. Princeton found her too. And a few years later, well, maybe not so many, Princeton found all of you. Class of 2023, we must flourish where we are found. As you leave here today, know this, there is always a place for you here. And there is always a world out there waiting to find you, waiting to find your heart, to find your brains, to find your might, and to find your voice. To this day, I still have classmates who tease me because my slogan when I ran for vice president of the class my freshman year was Mouth of the South. And I have to tell you, it still tickles me today when they call me that. I graduated from Princeton some 20 years after the civil rights activists crossed the Edmund Pettus Bridge. By the time I graduated, I had lived through a hostage crisis, an oil crisis, the end of the Cold War, and the women's movement. By the same token, you, class of 2023, are graduating some 20 years after 9/11. You have endured unprecedented times, a global pandemic, an insurrection, climate crisis, a racial reckoning. You have seen Me Too go from hashtag to a movement and social media go from connective to divisive. Our nation needs you. Humanity needs you now more than ever, not just to succeed, but to serve, to spread seeds of service wherever you go. Class of 2023, service can take lots of forms. For me, it's all about civic engagement. You cannot, you must not leave this place and not serve. How you serve is up to you, but that you serve, it's a mandate. Hear me loud and clear. The cost of apathy is great, and when people like you decide not to participate, we all lose. Progress is a never-ending struggle. Old battles become new again. Each generation must fight to hold on to the wins of the past and fight again for more gains. And there is nothing easy about that. But I believe that when we have the courage to see the flaws in our system, when we have the courage to come together and harness our power to fix these flaws, progress remains within our reach. I believe that when you lift up the most vulnerable in our society, when we distribute resources equitably, then we can increase opportunity. It is said that a rising tide lifts all boats, and so it does. Now, as I take my seat, I want to leave you with my favorite quote. It was from Shirley Chisholm, who was the first Black woman elected to Congress. I got a chance to meet and interview her for my Princeton thesis. My Princeton thesis was entitled, Black Women in Politics, Our Time Has Come. That was back in 1986. But I have to tell you, with 120 women in Congress serving right now, our time is now. Shirley Chisholm said that service is the rent we pay for the privilege of living on this earth. Class of 2023, as you enter the next chapter of your life, I am asking you to make a deposit on that rent by having a season of service. Whether you're bloom where you're planted or transplanted lots of miles away, have a season of service. Your season of service doesn't necessarily have to be electoral politics, but if it is, I have a card to give you after the speech. Whether you flourish where you're found or are the one doing the finding, please have a season of service. It doesn't have to be a lifetime, but to whom much is given, much is required. My mom used to say, those of us who are blessed must be a blessing to others. You cannot walk around this campus, suck in this air, learn from these brilliant people, and decide to do only the thing that will make you wealthier, happier, and more secure. You have to take a chance. Civic engagement is our birthright. Please, no matter what you do, vote. Vote like your life depends upon it. Whether you spread seeds of service or kindness or happiness or brilliance, have a season of service. Your season of service is the return on investment that Princeton made in you. You don't have to run for Congress, but I sure hope that you will run for local offices all across this nation. Lend your voice to a cause near and dear to your heart. Use your talents to solve problems, big and small. And by all means, vote. Did I say vote? Vote. You have to volunteer, you have to organize, and you have to turn out and elect officials that will do the right thing. And when you do that, you are not only participating, you're not only engaging, but you're making the world a better place. I had the great honor of having as my special guest at the State of the Union in 2015, Miss Amelia Boynton Robinson. Miss Amelia was 103 years old, and at the time was the oldest living survivor of Bloody Sunday. She was bludgeoned on that bridge in Selma, Alabama in 1965. She was precious cargo. I got a chance to have her as my special guest, and as we waited in the little anteroom for the president to walk through before he gave his speech, his cabinet to a person said the same thing. Oh, Miss Amelia, we stand on your shoulders. Oh, Miss Amelia, we wouldn't be here if it wasn't for people like you. Oh, Miss Amelia, we stand on your shoulders. So when Eric Holder, who was the then AG, knelt down beside her and said, oh, Miss Amelia, I stand on your shoulders. She said, get off my shoulders, all of you. Do your own work. Do your own work. And there's lots of work to be done. It's actually a post-it on my mirror, both in Washington, D.C. and in Alabama. When the president finally came, she literally cradled Barack Obama's face in his hands, in her hands, and there wasn't a dry eye in the room. He said, Miss Amelia, I'm about to give a speech in a few minutes as the President of the United States of America, and I do so because of you. She looked up, she looked at him, and she said, make it a good one! That better be a really good speech. Please, class of 2023, make every day a good one. Make every day and everything you do be good. We need you as a nation to remember the mandate of this university. Princeton in the nation's service and in the service of humanity. May God bless you, keep you, and may you remember that Princeton will always be here for you. Thank you.
Wow, that was amazing. Can we give it up one more time for Congresswoman Sewell, please?
Woo! I get a do-over! I love it!
She's excited about the jacket.
I'm excited about the year!
But thank you so much for your words, your commitment to service, leadership, and excellence, and for inviting all voices to the table. As somebody from the South, it really means a lot for me personally. And in recognition of your commitment to service in this nation, it is now my honor to induct you into the great class of 2023.
Yay!
At this time, I would like to welcome the senior singers of Old Nassau.
Thank you all for attending class day. We've been through so much as a class, whether it be the first time we were scared by the campus fox or the spontaneous celebrations at the Spia Fountain after finally returning to campus 2 full years later. We're so thankful that despite everything, we are here today at the best place of all, or really any place that isn't Cambridge, Massachusetts. Sorry, Dean Nunn. We may go our separate ways tomorrow, but with reunions, our memories, and our perseverance as a class, I know that our traditions will never graduate. Let's go.
Yeah.
This concludes our program, and wow, I have not seen a collection of tigers this hungry since 2 a.m. a few weeks ago at late meal, or maybe the Taco Bell stand. I don't know. Seniors, don't worry. You can pick up your box lunches. I'm so sorry. You can pick up your box lunches for your guests at Alexander Beach, and we look forward to seeing you tonight at the Step Sing. Congratulations again to the great Princeton class of 2023.